Good evening all. I'm Shalvi, research scholar of Amity Institute of Forensic Sciences and currently working in as a scientific assistant in Forensic Science Laboratory, Delhi. I'm here to represent my poster which states that recent advancement on determination of arsenic traces by electrochemical sensor and approach toward a lab on chip. It is basically depends on the review article, what I have gone through during my research period. The electrical portion I'll discuss later. First, I'll discuss with arsenic portion. We all know and aware about arsenic. It is a metallic irritant. There are numerous compounds of arsenic present in the environment, but some of them are more toxic, such as arsenic trioxide, arsenic pentoxide. Why? Because it is electrostatically stable than others. Therefore, they are most opted form for detection. Next slide, please. As in forensic field, to detect a heavy metal, there are numerous of technology which we have gone through during our study period, like Rhine's test. Basically, it is a microscopic test, but for confirmatory and for the quantitative value, we have to run our sample on highly equipped instruments such as ICP, MS, ICP, OES, AAS, as well as UV visible spectrophotometer. So what I'm here to tell you that the detection level, for the detection technique, we have to run our sample on a well-expertized manner. So I'll get back into this later. Then how can we skip those chemical fiasco into a lab on chip based system? So arsenic mode of administration is very simple. It can easily be spiked into any medium such as water, coffee, tea, etc. because it is a masking agent. I don't know how many of you are aware, like one of the DRDO scientists recently stated that he's been spiking with arsenic poisoner from the last few weeks, months or year. He was not aware that he's been spiking with arsenic in his digestible items. So in that scenario, it is very, very high time to do a technique which can be able to detect arsenic on the spot. So in that way, we have focused on some of the techniques which are present and we are not incorporating right now with the forensic field, like sensors. We all know about the sensors, but we haven't incorporated those technique in forensic toxicology field right now. So so we all know that arsenic, how it when it gets absorbed in our body, it act as an inhibitor. Ma'am, next slide. This is the chart with which I have incorporated in this, like when it get into the body, it inhibits the succinic dehydrogenase and leads to the uncoupling of oxidative phosphorylation and increases the loss of ATP. It intentionally binds with the hemoglobin and causes the multiple failure organs, which leads to death as well when it gets more into fatal doses. So arsenic is so stable that, interestingly, it is so stable that it can be able to detect from nail, bone, hair, and obviously vital organs. So it is primarily, we can detect arsenic antemortem side as well as postmortem side. So it becomes very, very important. Next slide. Yes. Now we'll talk about the sensor. How can we able to incorporate the sensor technique, which has been widely using by other industries like food tech, nanotech. So how can we relate those with the forensic? It is very important right now, because we don't want to go into the lab to run our samples. We want our result on the spot. For that concern, we all should merge towards the sensor techniques. Sensor is please stay on this slide. Sensor is basically nothing but a device that measures physical input from its environment and converts the data and can interpret it by machine like voltameters, potentiometers, etc. So basically, sensor is divided into three parts: working, transducer, electronics. I'll explain one by one. Like working is a place where we incorporate the components Like, for example, for biosensor, if we are talking about biosensors, the working electrode, a working space, we can incorporate with the biocomponents like antibody, enzymes, DNA strain, etc. In the respect of the studies. For nanocomposites like silica cap, graphene cap, gold or silver particles can be used as a component for the working. Transducer here act as a transformer. Like it basically transforms the signals which are produced by the working site after the interaction, and it converts the signal into a voltmeter, that it takes the information from the working site and convert it into a signal which can be able to depict by the electronic instrument later, which is connected with it. Like we can connect the electronic instrument with the cyclic voltammetry, DPV or LSVP, etc. Those are the voltammeters which are already been using by other industries, which are depends upon the conduction procedure. Next slide, ma'am. Okay, these are the images which is showing. Like first image is the brief idea about the screen printing electrode, and the second 3D figure, which is a depiction of a biosensor. Working electrode, I've already mentioned that it can be modified into these mentioned areas, and these reference and auxiliary electrode, or we can say the counter. All these criteria are based upon the conduction. Like if we are providing some kind of potential current, all the results will depend upon the its electricity influence under the electrochemical cell. If we are talking about the arsenic, if we are incorporating the arsenic with some of the specific or selective nanocomposites like gold nanoparticles, if we are incorporating the arsenic with gold nanoparticle and put on the working electrode, the area which is showing in the image right now, if we drop cast the nanocomposite on the working electrode and put it into a electrochemical channel, definitely it is going to depict some of the change in the peak, which can later be detected by the instrument, how much amount of arsenic present on that amount of sample. Next slide. And this is the graph. It is different from the potential chart. It is a colorimetric detection. If we are talking about the recent advancement, this is also a recent advancement in the field of detection level. Colorimetry is a protocol which to give a result on the spot based on the color detection. Here you can see the different color arsenic value showing with the rest of the other heavy metals. Why interesting right now? Because it is incorporated with the polyethylene glycol capped gold nanoparticles. All the abstract which I've mentioned is specific for the arsenic detection. All the rest was not been able to interact with the metal ion, interact with the nanocomposite because of the electrostatic relationship. So basically electrostatic relationship is main focus. Why? Because arsenic is having a sulfhydryl group. It can easily be able to interact with polyethylene glycol, and polyethylene glycol cap particles will interact with the gold nanoparticle. All the complexion which is created will be resulting into a blue color, and all the rest was not been able to produce that color. So here we can say that yes, polyethylene glycol was the specific for the arsenic. So there are so many studies are going around the world that how can be able to differentiate the other metal with others. So the nanocomposites are then playing role model for that. This is the image where, the previous slide please. Yes, here you can see the gold nanoparticle. AU is the representative of gold. So AU is a nanocomposite which we can use from various properties, like it can show the redox properties, fluorescence, as you can see the image, like it is giving the various different color, plasmon resonance, conductivity, dense mass. Here it is a cumulative study that yes, gold can be able to use for as a nanocomposite for all other metal, not only for arsenic.
Just shall we for the interruption, but the time allotted was 7 minutes and it is extended now, so you have to wrap up it as soon as possible, please.
Okay, sure ma'am, sure. So here, yes, this next slide, Alex, please take it. Ma'am, next slide.
Yeah, next.
Yeah, the ITO is the sheet. It is a conductive sheet. Like what we have got the gold is the specific for the metal detection. We can incorporate with graphene oxide as well. And this is the image which is depicting itself. Like we can use the ITO sheet as well for the chipset Arduino chipset electrode. For I can sum up, like in the summary what I have mentioned, that in the recent trend we can go through the nano level for the detection of arsenic and arsenic trioxide and arsenate, because both are more stable and opted this study. So in my knowledge, we can use this so that it helps us to avoid the chemical fiasco and lead towards the green forensics, which will be able to help for the environment as well as the handlers. So we should go for the sensor other than the heavy instrumentation. So my main criteria was to represent the review article on this type of nano sheet and nano technique, which can be helpful to detect the arsenic. So thank you so much. It is a very vast topic. I can't take too much time. So yeah, thank you.